Hello. Hello, everybody. Let me make sure I'm not muted. That happens to me far too often. It looks like I'm good. Okay. So, this is gonna be a very different stream than usual. I was at work today when I found out that someone, I call him a celebrity, but it's someone I really looked up to, passed away yesterday, and I did not know about it until today at work. And his name was Ken Block. He is an icon in the car world, and he was the co-founder of DC Shoes. He was the founder of Hoonigan, which is this great company, car company. And basically, 10 years ago, I looked up to him as a hero. I still did. I mean, until like even this present time. But he was known for creating these videos where he would do crazy things with his cars and like set up courses and drift to the courses all crazy and fast. And I had never and still have not seen anyone do what he did in cars. And I found it so inspiring at the time. So I thought instead of not streaming today, I thought I would just hang out with you guys and show you guys some of the videos that really shaped me when I was younger, like 10 years ago, when I was building my first car. I bought an old Volvo for $1,000 cash, and I ended up with friends. I swapped the motor, I swapped the suspension, I changed so many things on this car. And at this time, I was really like watching Ken Block's videos all the time. And at one point, I even tagged him when I posted a picture of my car when I was like 19. And he liked the picture. He went onto my profile, found a picture of my car, and liked it. And it made me so happy. And now I will always treasure that. So basically, I'm pretty bummed, very bummed about his passing. And he had a 16-year-old daughter who he was building a car for. They were almost done. They had a whole YouTube series about it. Sucks. Just sucks. He was snowmobiling with his family. That's how he passed. His snowmobile like flipped over on him. So despite all the crazy stuff that he'd done in his life with cars, that's what happened. And yeah, I'm really, really bummed. So we're just gonna watch some videos and try to remember the good things. I'm not gonna watch anything that's like him and his daughter. It'd be too much. So, I would just like to show you guys some videos today. We'll hang out for like an hour or so. Yeah, and maybe this will impact some of you the way that it impacted me. I'm obviously very into cars. I don't know, it's not everyone's cup of tea, but the things that he did and the videos he would produce and his production and his ideas were very unique. And I used to watch these videos projected. I would use a projector and put them on my wall. I just thought they were so cool. So, all right. So, we'll just get into this. I'm just gonna switch over and we'll just watch these videos and hang out. Very chill, low pressure stream. We're just existing. It was a coworker today that suggested to me that I should do this instead of not streaming. Just kind of pay tribute. But yeah. Hi, Sunny Bub. Hello. We're not doing Stray today. Sorry. Sorry if you were expecting Stray. A celebrity that I love dearly passed away yesterday, and I'm very bummed out about it. So I'm just gonna do like a short tribute stream and kind of introduce people to him if they are not familiar with him. His name was Ken Block. He was a pioneer in motorsports, basically. He would do actual rallies, competitions worldwide, but I mean, he changed my life when I was a teenager, 18, 19, and just figuring out how to work on cars. So, yeah, yeah, pretty rough. But I'm gonna turn this into kind of a good vibe. We're just gonna enjoy what he created, and he truly touched so many people. All right, before I get choked up, let's just start watching some videos. Okay, so we're just gonna go through these. Really, we're just gonna just hang out. And I encourage chat to just be normal. Like, I don't really want this to be too heavy of a vibe. But yeah, let's get into this. Let's do this. How are you, Sunny Bub? How's your day? How are you doing? Ugh. Rest in peace. For Miss Lois, you didn't have work today. Love that for you. That is so nice. Hope you're enjoying your day, just relaxing. When I was 19, chat, I wanted to be Ken Block so bad. He would basically get all of these, he would get the streets, sometimes the most of the city shut down so that he could do these videos. This one I believe is Los Angeles. I might be tripping. He did LA, San Francisco. He was partnered up with Monster Energy, Ford the brand, car brand. He's the co-founder of DC Shoes, so he had all these big partnerships and he was able to kind of like do this stuff. It was super cool. So it's all done safely. That's why it's so ironic he would pass from something like snowmobiling. Freaking kills me. But yeah. I know not everyone's into cars, but this was so cool to me. Just the maneuvers. I remember putting duct tape on the headlights of my car when I was younger, and I thought it was so cool. I just wanted to be like him. So cool, Chet. So cool. Like drifting backwards around a corner, like how he's going backwards. So cool. So cool. If anything, this whole thing has kind of just reinvigorated my desire to work on the Volvo. I'm not selling that car. I love it. I'm gonna get it back on the road and stuff because this is all taking me back to like 2012, and that was my main thing I had going on at the time, was that working on my car. And that passion never really leaves you. So such a beautiful car. I love all the LA traffic too behind him. To me, that's cinema. Nice. So nice. I can't. Good Lord. A legend. Possibly too good for this world. so close to those parking concrete things. Like, that's kind of the thing, is like, he, all these videos, you feel like he's invincible, you know? I always did. This was always my dream, to be able to have a closed course, you know, not risking police and tickets and stuff. Pirelli. Okay, I was trying to remember which tire sponsor he had. Pirelli Tires actually sponsored him, and his whole mantra was Tire Slayer. And I was always thinking it was so funny because, yeah, you can afford to be a tire slayer if Pirelli is on site to just give you new tires all the time. So I would always remind myself back in the day, like, you don't have unlimited tires, but don't do these things. But it's very tempting. I remember when he liked the picture of my car on Instagram, I dropped my phone. I was freaking out. And I checked it today. I went back and, like, in the old Instagram stuff, and I found it. And it was like, oh, cherish that forever. I can't. Oh, we have my mom in the chat. What is up? S Perry Photo, welcome. It reminds you of when I drove your Volvo for the first time. Bay Area, stand up. Oh, I would love these wheels on the Volvo. I already have something similar. They're called Hydras for the Volvo. And they're white. They're just like white, I think, five big spokes. Very pretty. But with the one green accent, I don't know. Oh, the Tarmac's 1552. I actually have, I don't have them right here with me, but I have 1552 coasters. That's how nerdy I am. Oh my god, I've taken this off-ramp so many times in my life. It's never this empty. Spoiler alert. You're always parked here on this off-ramp to get into the city. An old Ford Escort Cogsworth would be so cool. There was a better wheel that he has, John, in another video. It's like blue and purple, blue and pink, and it has all these like paint speckles on it. It's like the accent wheel or whatever. It's hot. I put that video in here. It's coming. But seeing him shred San Francisco really did make me happy. Look at that. Backwards, chat. Backwards. Hot. Like, look at that. I can't. And then this with the trolleys. Too cool. Is it loud enough, guys? Do we need more car noises? Let me know. I just love that cities would shut down. He was a very wealthy man. I mean, he was tied with, yeah, Monster, DC, Ford at this time. Unfortunately, last year, not unfortunately, whatever, he was gonna go back to Subaru, and he was currently with Subaru when he passed, but he had a long-standing Ford thing. Ooh, that jump, though! Oh my goodness. Dead. Deceased. I'd love to hear that call for real. Amanda, hello, hello. It's a little bit of a different stream today, Amanda. This man driving this amazing car in such an amazing fashion that you see, he was a stunt driver, an international rally driver, and he passed away yesterday, and I'm very upset. So we're watching my favorite videos of his today to just kind of honor him. I'm very into cars, and when I was a teenager, he was a big, big hero of mine. And I'm just kind of in shock at the news. It was an accident, a snowmobile accident. So, not to bring down the mood, but we are here honoring someone's life today. And tomorrow I'll be back with Stray, but Amanda, I really do appreciate you saying that, because sometimes when I don't feel good, it is very hard to hit that go live button, so my favorite part of the day is seeing you pop up in chat. Thank you, Amanda. Yeah, we're just watching fun car videos. These videos got me through my early 20s, that's for sure. Look at that, chat. Look at that air. And the way the suspension just eats it. It just takes it. Oh my god, not the ad! Not the ad! Okay. Okay, we're good. We're good. We're good. Not the cursed gaming ad. Move the cursor. Thank you, Amanda. How's your day, Amanda? What you been up to? Look at those corners. It's 222 in California, guys. Make a wish. He got air sideways, upwards and sideways. delicious. Hang on. Just give me a second here. I haven't watched these in a long time. It's probably been 5 years. This is me on my way to buy groceries in my Volvo. Rest in power. And this is Travis Pastrana, who was good friends with him. I saw his tribute to him and it like broke my heart. But when I was a kid, like 10 years old, Travis Pastrana was a big deal. I guess he probably still is. But they were buddies. Major vroom. So much vroom. Back at work, feeling okay about it. I'm glad it's a chill day. You deserve it. Pastrana does Gymkhana? I did not know that. Pastrana Khanna. He's the new driver? Oh my gosh. Maybe he'll kind of carry the torch. I mean, they were really good friends. His poor daughter. I can't stop thinking about it. Beautiful. See, this is beautiful Northern California. Way better than the LA video. Just saying. Gorgeous. I've always wanted to drive a rally course, and maybe now I'll actually put it on my bucket list instead of writing it off. A lot of people have said today that Ken wouldn't want us to be sad, and it is true. His car's smoking. It looked like it was. Oh my gosh. I can't. I don't even care if I get copyrighted on this chat. This is a moment. This is fine. On board, I'm the captain. So climb aboard. I'll try. Oh Lord, I'll try. All right, I can't. Oh my gosh. It's so beautiful. We're good. We're good. What's up, Luis? Luis, are you a car guy? Are you aware of Ken Block? Also, thank you for being here. I hope you're okay. You're on the clock. Oh my goodness. All right, I can't. All right, we're moving on. Next one. Global booze emojis? Yeah, there's not enough. Not a car guy, but you're aware of Ken? Yeah. He was such a big inspiration to me when I was young. I was probably like 19. Learning how to work on cars, and I even got him to like a picture of my car on Instagram by tagging him. He seemed like such a real guy. And I used to love watching these videos. I would watch these, like, muted with music when I was just partying. But the way he works with cars, the way, what he could do with cars was just so cool, so inspiring. And to this day, one of my cars has a little Hoonigan sticker on it. And I will treasure that. Yeah, I just checked today. I looked at Instagram and the like is still there on my car. And I was like, oh my gosh. But yeah, he was 55 years old and he passed in a snowmobile accident of all things yesterday. Snowmobiling with his family on the second day of the new year, like, breaks my heart. Also, we're not watching this ad. Oh, he co-founded DC Shoes. I know you guys know DC Shoes. The like lives on. I know it's still there. I was like, oh. But these videos give me serotonin, so here we are. I'm just trying to gain the serotonin. How have you been, Luis? How was your new year? I haven't seen you in a little while. How are you? This is how I want to behave in every roundabout, and I won't lie about it. Cynical, if you're still out there, this car has the uni-wiper. I was just talking to him yesterday about how I wish I had one windshield wiper on my car, like a rally car. This car has it. It looks cool. It's just cool. Who needs two windshield wipers? You got one. One windshield, one wiper. Oh, you spent it at Schubert's and J-Puff's house. We love it. They are amazing hosts, it is true. I was getting some FOMO about the New Year's party. I just took shrooms at home by myself. It was still fun, though. But I wish I was partying with y'all. That sideways over the curb? Hot. Let's go back. Computer, go back. Imagine. They put a ramp. I saw the ramp, but still, I mean, jeez Louise. Yeah, see, Cynical, you understand the uni-wiper. See, he did all of this crazy shit, all of this life-risking stuff with his car, and then he passes in a snowmobile accident. Breaking my damn heart, Ken Block. So nice. This'll be me and my Volvo someday, you guys. I'll be a streamer and a rally driver. Just watch. She has the suspension. Not really the motor or the turbo, but the suspension, yes. Solid steel frame. I'll see you guys in Sweden. I think this was my favorite part of the San Francisco video because he is so close to the ocean. This gave me so many fears. Like, look at that! I can't! Chat, come on. That's insane. He made it look so easy though, so fun. Yo, this guy can drive, literally. J-Puff, he gets air. Like, he'll jump and get air. He goes sideways, backwards. It would have been a blast if you were there, jelly of your trip. Dude, I had so much fun with you guys, and I wish it could have been longer. Life is uncertain. There we go. Yeah, it was fun. My actual trip was okay. It wasn't crazy. I wanted it to be crazy, and it was only mild, but I'll take mild. His control looked so effortless. That was the thing. It's like he never really looked like it was difficult. He really did change the industry, and I think a lot of us are probably just in shock. You want to drive like this, Amanda? I support you. The anxiety disorders. Oh my gosh, look though, Amanda. This would be so fun. This is how I kind of used to try to drive when I was 18. I calmed down in my older age. But my car, my first car, the one I have always driven until like recently, it's rear wheel drive. So I would try to like get loose around corners all the time. And then I put the racing suspension in the car, and so it has like these amazing like bright blue shocks and struts. Maybe this will like reinvigorate my passion for cars. donuts around the table. Yeah, I mean, he just, it's all like a game to him. It's literally a playground. It's just fascinating to watch. He's just having fun. Rest in peace. Rest in peace to the god. Major vrooming. It is so fun, Amanda, when you actually hear the vroom noises and you're going. It is very fun. Mario Kart in real life. Blown engines and shredded tires. I wonder how often he actually had engine problems. I know tires, obviously. He would go through them like crazy. But he was sponsored by Pirelli, so, you know. But the engines, that is a good question. Look at him. Look at him just having fun. He's just chilling in the middle of the rising bridge. Rest in peace, homie. Next, so this one was honestly, this one might be my favorite because of the course. I don't know. When I was younger, I thought this was the best one, but San Francisco might be my favorite. I don't know. But this one is the most obstacle course type one, where they actually built this crazy course. I have watched this so many times. Driving on a raising bridge when you can barely see. Yeah, it's just like you're surrounded by a smoke cloud. You can't get much cooler. J-Puff, I don't know if you were here when I said it, but this guy liked a picture of my Volvo on Instagram in 2012. That's my Ken Block memory that I will take to my grave, is that he reached out and liked a picture of my car because I tagged him, and that made me happy because I was a kid and very proud of my car. And it was a piece of shit. A lot of people would say it was a bad car, but I loved it. And you got this guy sponsored to all hell liking my car. I was like, very appreciative. Yeah, it made me really happy. I still am proud of that car. She's literally just parked right outside. It's like never far from me. John, if you're still in chat, this is the wheel I was talking about that I like. It's this colorway. It's like blue and purple. It's in the front there. It's hot. That's very hot. Looks so fun. Like, imagine being able to just release your stress this way. Still a tarmac. Yeah, I like the cover. That's what I'm saying, the aero disc. And also the way the back end of the car hits that. Look at that. Bam. Planning your drift so that the rear end is hitting all these things. That's why this was my favorite video. Probably, and also the wheel cover. Sexy. Also, getting these, the construction equipment to, like, pose. Hilarious. I think, I don't even have chatbot active, but Potatoes, you get better version, I will say it. Potatoes is lurking. We appreciate you. And we'll be here when you come back, hopefully, probably. Thank you, Potatoes. Look at them go. The car that spits fire. Yeah, it's a chatbot. I didn't open it today because I didn't want sound effects going off because I'm like somber AF. So. Honestly, J-Puff, it's not a dumb question. I think you can do either rear or front. It's more about the internals. And you'll notice in his cabin, he has this ginormous shift lever. Like, it's mostly about what the transmission is doing, I think, more so than the suspension, or like rear versus front. But I'm pretty sure this Ford Fiesta, I'm pretty sure, is front-wheel drive. It is just outfitted to the T. And he can shift by pulling this lever forward and backwards. It's not in any kind of a sideways. I never really knew the exact. I was just mostly impressed with his maneuverability. precision, and he would compete on international stages with rallies, and he would place very well. Like, he represented America very well internationally for motorsports. Look at how he jumps off that ramp sideways. Kill me now. Look at him go. It's just, okay, this ball, this had me in a chokehold. I don't know why. I think it's a moving target, and he's just like, maybe it's the camera view? I don't know. I was dead at this. And he would always wear sunglasses. It's like, how do you see anything, dude? All-wheel drive. Okay. His Gymkhana cars are all-wheel drive. Thank you. Good knowledge. Into the tunnel. No problem at all. Like, this thing turns on a dime, like the way that he has it set up and how he drives. I don't know if that's my favorite, but it was the most impressive. I always thought it was so impressive. Okay, so this one, more of the Ford, the Mustang. He's on Pike's Peak. I remember this one. Oh my god, rest in peace. I just, like, can't even process. 1400 horsepower. 1400 horsepower. Oh. Hitting the e-brake. My smooth brain can't understand how he makes these floating turns. Yeah, I think it's like however he has the braking set up, the e-braking. Because you'll see some of the cameras, it's like it actually, the tire is not moving. So yeah, he's just sliding. But he has that tire sponsorship, so they're on site ready to swap them out. I think mostly it's the cornering. I have always looked up to him as how he corners. Not to brag, but I'm pretty good at cornering myself. And I've always wanted to do rally because I learned how to drive in the woods. You're looking out for deer. It's two lanes, you know. It's lots of curves, but if you don't think there's anyone around, you can go pretty fast. And so, maybe I will. Maybe I'll be a rally driver, chat, and I'll be a streamer on the side. You never know. Look at that. Yeah, I think in that case, you're literally just hitting the e-brake to just meow. Hot. Goodness. The turbo sounds? I'm sorry. That whistling? This course was in one of the Forza games? Cool. In the Tokyo Drift film, Pike's Peak. Very famous. Echo, hello, hello. We are paying tribute to one of my favorite ever motorsports icons. Someone who passed yesterday. I'm just watching my favorite videos of him. I hope you're having a good day, Echo. I'm sending you all the good vibes. Ooh, that wheel. Hot. Literally hot. He brought out the helicopter, chat. Hot wheels. The turbo just venting into the air. Ridiculously sexy, this car. don't like to be morbid or disrespectful, chat, but I just wonder about who his cars are going to. What is going to happen to all of Ken Block's possessions? I would assume his wife and daughter are going to get everything. But, like, what will they do with the cars? These things are... It's one of a kind. There's nothing like this. I don't know. It hurts. It hurts my soul. Look at him blocking out the light. That's adorbs. That's me, literally. Ken Blocky, just like me. It does make me want to go fix up my car, though, and shred it up. God, this road would be so fun to drive. But scary. It honestly is so scary. His daughter is racing this car. That hurts. I mean, it's good, but it hurts. How do you deal with losing your dad? She's only 16. Unicorn versus the world. Well, we'll see what happens. Oh god, this looks sketchy. Oh, so nice. Oh my goodness. There goes my hero. Watch him as he goes. Look at that. He said a little sprinkle of dust there for everybody. Mario Kart drifting is shaking. Shaking, crying, and throwing up. His ability to turn the car on its nose and like rotate around a small object after doing all these crazy turns, like, it just had me in a chokehold, chat. I wanted to learn how to do this. It's kind of like I used to ride horses and you would do barrel racing where you're running around all these barrels. It's kind of the same concept, except with a car, it's obviously not a live animal. So you're in charge of all the controls, but it's kind of the same concept with horses. It's how fast can you turn on a dime. I guess I've always been an adrenaline junkie. It's what I'm coming to terms with here. Driving, looking out the side window. I know, literally just taking in the sights. There's a video of an Evo falling off a cliff. Oh, that's rough. See, no fear in this man's body. No fear. How do you even see out of that helmet visor? Oof, those sounds. Those could lull me to sleep. Rest in peace, King. No one is ever gonna do it like this. Just a fact. Look at that. Barely kissed it. Here he goes. J-Puff, this is average footage of you going to get kolaches. Before the place closes. Ken, you are a legend. Absolute legend. Please stop. Please stop with this. It's fine. It's totally fine.
Dallas, coward, ride the cold. Rise above, we're gonna rise above. Make this score what we say. Rise above, we're gonna rise above.
My heart, my livable heart.
What we do. Rise above, we're gonna rise above. We are tired of your abuse. Try to stop us,
but there's no
use. Rise above, rise above.
All right. All right, next one. Next one. We're just going on the Ken Block marathon. The blockathon. Gotta get that girl. Rest in peace, homie. Rest in peace to the god. 650 horsepower. Ooh, here we go. So this one's in France. That little mouse go. Rest in peace, you absolute animal. Hit in the half pipe. I can't. Oh my god. Wait. Wow. Look at him go. Sideways. Obama can't Gymkhana, please. Please. Was that like a dog whistle? I hope not. Don't ruin this for me. It's probably just a meme. We'll just go with that. It's just a meme. This poor guy, he looks like literally so scary. It would be so satisfying to be pulling that lever. That's all I'm saying. Look at that with the wet track. Chat. Is anyone seeing this? Yeah, Ken, you know you're cool. Let's go back. Let's rewind that. Let's all take a moment. This is where I am mentally every single day. Is this. This is fine. Go, King, go. I might be wrong, guys, but I think that he invented Gymkhana. I'm pretty sure this is his style of driving, and he popularized it, and it was very popular, so now it's a thing. I don't think that people did it before him. Setting up a course. I mean, rallying obviously exists, but cones and shit, like weird obstacles, like Gymkhana is not, I don't think it was a thing before he did it. Gymkhana is a horse term, I'm pretty sure. I used to do Gymkhana, so to see it in cars is just like amazing. Because I don't want to get super corny, but it's like you get in tune with your beast, your machine. It's a horse or it's a car. It's like you have something, and cars are measured in horsepower. It's like this very powerful thing, stronger than you, and you can turn it on its nose. Kindly, of course, through only positive reinforcement. I mean, no sarcasm. When you hydroplane intentionally, exactly. The wheels are a bucket list? I agree. I agree with that. He spin me right round. Not on the scale? For sure. He did have the budget. I mean, that might separate him from everyone else, but in all fairness, I'm pretty sure he came from pretty much nothing. Not a nepotism baby, like literally just a good driver. And clearly someone with a vision for media, because how he produced these videos, this defined him. There's plenty of great F1 drivers, we don't know their names, but they can do stuff like this. It's just that this is what he spent his time doing and could pay for it and have cities shut down their streets and film videos. Look at this. Like the upwards over the cone. Like I said, I now respect Ford Fiestas more than I ever did. Very nice. That looks so fun. Look at him, having the time of his life. Rest in peace. So, I found the picture that he liked of my car, and I will try and show it on the webcam if it works. October 2012, so just over 10 years ago. This way. Anyway, it's my car. It's a little Volvo, and it has rally lamps that I drilled into the bumper. Ken Block liked this 10 years ago. Take my word for it, Chad, it's true. It was my one little thing. And I'll never forget it. Alright, this is the last video I have, guys. Y'all ain't pulling up like we pulling up. I don't want to hear anybody talking about pulling up. Yo, this shit cold. Go, Ken, go. I want to thank you guys for being here with me today. We're going to watch this video and then I'll probably cut out. This man was a visionary and really did push me through my early years of adulthood, young adulthood, working on my car and thinking about what is possible in the world of modifying vehicles. And for him to reach out directly and support me made so much of a difference. This video made me love Subarus. I feel for his wife, for his daughter. Anyone who knew him, honestly, he was an amazing person. And America is gonna suffer because he was one of our best as far as rallying goes, so. All of the blessings. I hate to start the new year on this kind of a foot, but we're just gonna pay tribute, so. Thank you guys for being here. Let's finish this out strong. Who doesn't love a Subaru, chat? Subarus are hot. I'm not afraid to say it. I'm really not. I'm not afraid. Hmm. My mom has a Subaru. That's what she learned to drive in. To be fair, my dad had a Volvo, and that's how I learned. And I feel like both of those are mom cars, so. Grocery getters, as they're called in the car world. But you can have a sleeper, which is a grocery getter on the outside, but on the inside, I will smoke you at red lights. That's what I consider a sleeper. Subaru Outback, baby. He's living his best life. And it was a good life. I think we should watch the San Francisco one more time to end it after this. That's what I'll do, because that is my favorite. I was there. I literally saw the tire marks on the street. I was literally 20 years old. It hurts. I'll survive. There he goes. Breaking, look at all this. Bam, bam, bam. He breaks all of these lights. Look at that chat. Hyundai Civic. This is the Hyundai Civic. Pull up. Pretty sure that releases like toxic gases every time you break one of those, but whatever. I love this. I love this. Look how close. Like, when the wheels are turning but the car's not moving, bless your soul, Ken. I miss you already. He knocks the ball out of this guy's hand. Watch. Watch this. Look at this approach. The planning. He says, bonk. Bonk. Got it. Just the hand. Like, you can get your car to just, like, goals. Ken was such a badass, he wouldn't want people to be sad today, so honestly, this has helped me a lot. Who dis? Who dis? Is it Pastrana again? Deer Deck? I think this is Deer Deck. When boys have too much money. Drives off with the paintball stains on the windshield. Yeah, that's Deer Deck. I thought so. Those turbo noises are just chef's kiss. Go, Ken, go. Go, Ken, go. He's smiling. He knows it's crazy. This is crazy. Too cool for school. Okay, so we're gonna watch San Francisco one more time and then we'll call it. But yeah, I want to thank you guys for being here, because this was hard. I like was pretty depressed and I feel a lot better, so thank you. And treasure your life. Tell your loved ones you love them, because literally this freaking man died in a snowmobile accident yesterday. He risked his life every day for this sport and it did not kill him. Just appreciate the people around you, because you don't know how short life is. And I've been taught that lesson a few too many times in the last year, so I love you guys. And guess what? Tomorrow we play Stray. Tomorrow we'd be back in the cat game. I just need today to reflect. Go, Ken, go. That open road feeling must be so nice in San Francisco. No one ever gets that feeling. That is a luxury we don't have. Go, Ken, go. From broom to meow. Thank you, Amanda. I'm happy I actually got here. I thought about not streaming, but it's not right. It's like, you should try to honor this person and explain to people why I'm down. Like, it's not fair to just dip out on the community. I'm just kind of tired about hearing people die. I wish people could stop fucking dying. And I'm sorry to be so blunt, but it's like, I'm really just, I can't handle much more of this. And I will still handle it, it's just I don't want to. I don't want to hear this. This is someone who viewed a picture of my little car that I've been working on my own and liked it. Like, I feel like we're connected in a way, you know? Or we were. He supported someone who was just doing their own thing. Like, the car world is very cool sometimes because someone who's made it, who's a millionaire, can still appreciate what it's like to be in your garage with all your shitty tools, with oil on your jeans, you know? And it meant a lot to me. And it still does. And I will never sell that car. I've always felt that way, but I mean, even more so now, it's like, people say Ken wouldn't want people to be sad. I think that he would also want people to pursue their passion. And I am passionate about that car. It's like, I will get it back on the road. Glad you did this. His little smile. I know he totally smiles. He knows he's killing it. It's the outro with the stick song. That's why I want to do this again. Look at this tiny box. He puts himself in this little box and he's just doing circles. And he doesn't knock anything over. Yeah, he knows he's the one. I'm not even kidding. I'm not trying to just like blow smoke up his ass, but it's like no one does what he does the same way. He was one of a kind. Look at that. This is San Francisco. Neom. Look at that. Look at it. I can't. Boing. Zoom in. He just, like, lands, just takes that. Like, okay, I just soared through the air in San Francisco. Oh, I'm so glad, Amanda, because this is my favorite one. He literally had most of the city blocked off for this. And I actually went to San Francisco to go to a party, a concert, and I saw the tire marks on the streets, and it made me really happy. This is 2011 or 2012. Back then, he was like so important to me in my car journey. A lot of locals were upset that he like closed off the city for this video, but it's a short video. It's like one day of filming. Look at that. Look at it. I can't imagine. Okay, no ads. Oh my god, you guys, hang with me, hang with me. Okay, we're done. That was rough. The car just flips on its nose, the way that he brakes. Those game ads are so cursed, yeah. It's like, would you kill your wife? It's like, shut up, I'm literally just trying to watch this video. Better to celebrate life than focus on death. Thank you, cynical. I'm glad too, I pushed myself. I was like, I could wallow in sadness, or I could be here for people and hang out with people. And maybe people that didn't know about Ken Block, and I can share this. Because this guy was so nice to me, And he's just so impactful on the community of cars, and I wish if I could just kind of spread that, you know, makes me happy. Okay, here's Travis Pastrana. Amanda, you might know him from the X Games. Travis and Ken were very good friends. Clearly. He's just chillin'. Their amygdalas simply don't work. Love that for them. Yeah, can you imagine not having any kind of stress or worry about your bodily life? I think that's why it hit me hard to hear that he passed of something kind of so small as a snowmobile. Because I've watched Ken Block do things like this for 10 years and I'm like, what? He was snowmobiling with his family? I don't like to believe it. Anyway, we will celebrate this outro. And you guys, I will be back tomorrow and we will be playing Stray. I just need it today. This is just a lot. He liked to picture my car. I'm gonna treasure that forever because I love that car. That's my baby. And my heart just goes out to his family. He inspired me, that's for sure. And I know a lot of other people. So thank you guys for being here. We're gonna cut it off. I will be back tomorrow. I want you guys to just think about the people in your life, and you might want to tell them that you care about them, because this kind of thing can happen to anybody. It doesn't matter how much of an impact you make on the world. We are all not invincible. And this guy did stunts that risked his life every day and wasn't even close. But I love you guys. Thank you. Thank you for being here for this. This was just my way of processing this. And I will be back tomorrow with normal content. We be gaming chat. I'm just gonna continue to cry and pour one out for this guy, because he changed my life. But thank you for sticking around and watching this, because I feel like I can kind of share it. So, I hope you guys have a great day. A great day. Let's start the New Year's, like, on a better note. Let's, like, restart the New Year's. I appreciate you. I will be here tomorrow at 2 p.m. Pacific. Bet your bottom dollar. And I hope everyone has a great day. Like I said, tell people you love them. It matters. Thank you, Amanda. You're the best. Alright, guys. I will see you in about 24 hours, maybe less. Have a great day. You're all amazing. Don't doubt yourself ever. It's not worth it.